Guys, welcome to this video. We are going to see how to make very personalized tracks with the newest FLStudio 11. In case you find mistakes in pronunciation, please leave feedbacks in comments. Watch this video if you already know the very basics of this software. First of all, while creating your project, you start making each pattern for beats, melody, bass line, and so on. This can be made putting on and off the steps for each channel. However, you can further edit channels using the options in the top right corner. Select a channel clicking next to its name, then click on Keyboard Editor. A new small window will right appear below the channel selected. In this mini piano roll, you can edit the tone and the note of each step. Clicking on other steps in active will make them on in the pattern. The default tone is indicated through a light red bass line shown. Use your mouse wheel to scroll the piano roll on higher or lower notes. Click again on the keyboard icon to close it. Next to it you have the graph editor, used to change properties of your channel steps in time. Scroll the bar to choose the property. Then drag the column's height to change value. Each column is a channel step. Keep your pattern played in loop to hear how it changes meanwhile. A deeper way to edit these channels is using the piano roll window. Click on the third button from the left in your corner. This works just like the keyboard editor, but more into deep and in detail. You can work in the piano roll in the same way seen for the playlist window, since you do have the same buttons in the top left corner that make the same functions. What does change is that you are not going to spread patterns, but notes related to the channel selected first. You can change anytime which channel to edit. Just click next to the piano roll in the title and choose the channel. So use the pencil or the brush button to add notes. These are described according to the music standards. The letter means the note, the number the octave in the scale. The higher is such note, the higher is the frequency in output. Notes can be moved if you drag them. You can edit their length, editing their edges. To avoid the snappings, just hold Alt down. In this window you can personalize each note. Below the piano roll you have a sort of diagram. This describes, for each note added, the value of the property chosen above, next to the channel name under the first list. So if you choose velocity and put a lower height on a note, this will be less intense in output. If you want to edit properties throughout the whole channel, select one of the channel properties list and spread the graph holding your mouse down. Make sure to play your channel on and on. With the path light on, press space and listen to how the channel changes at each note. When you are done, just close the piano roll. The edited channel is no more shown with the channel steps, but it is described through the structure inserted through the piano roll before. Make sure to respect the beats per bar that the pattern has. If you put a note too much far in time, the pattern risks to last more than its own beats per bar set. And this is a problem, because the other channels set with the pattern's original duration stay off until the long channel will finish its duration. So keep in mind to put such long channels in new patterns, and totally on their own and aside. You have read presets to make great loops in the piano roll. In your browser window go to Scores and, on the channel interested, drag any loop with this icon. Remember to put off any active step in the channel that is going to have notes through the piano roll. If you don't do this, you will hear in output both notes and steps made active. Plus, you won't be able to see the piano notes in the pattern. You can edit your patterns much deeper using the mixer window. Open it through the fifth icon from the left. The mixer is related to the opened pattern and shows you three main kinds of outputs. The master collects all overall output of the pattern with its channels. Then you have the imported channels and the send ones. Each slot is a decibel meter that says for each channel imported and the master how is the intensity. Make sure it never gets red in color. To import all the channels, select one from the opener pattern and right click on a slot and go to Link Selected Channels. Scroll the slots list using your mouse wheel. Very important to edit channels and add effects to them is how to use insert slots. You have the sends as well that collect together outputs of insert slots in different percentages. Just select the insert slot you want to add in one of the send slots. The first orange icon at the bottom states which channel you are adding in other slots in the mixer. Click then on the icon in slots you want to add this channel. A knob will appear making you set how much of the channel selected must be transferred in such slot. In the same slot you can add a percentage of another channel. Just select it and activate the knob on the same send slot, in this case. You are actually mixing channels together. Note that you can mix up channels not just on send slots, but on insert ones or the master itself. You are totally free. Below each slot you can edit such channels imported. The semi-circumference sets the panning. The small green light means channel on. Click on it to make it muted. The vertical bar sets the volume. The two icons on the right lets you switch left with right stereo channel and positive with negative waveform amplitudes. The FX icon is used to make effects applied on or off. The watch one sets any delay. Click on it and choose how to put such a delay and insert values. Use reset to delete the effect. On the right you find the in and the out panels. In lets you add effects and plugins to the channel selected in the mixer. The left arrow on the right will show you the full list of all effects and editings you can add. To have a general overlook on effects, watch the related video in this show. Once the effect is added, this will occupy one of the seven rows. On the right you can turn on and off such effect, and through the knobs you can make louder or less the effect itself in output. The outside works with the output signal that comes from the master. This has all to add a filter fast. You can use the knobs and the bars, or you can drag through your mouse directly on the graph shown. Very, very useful are the mixer presets. If you want to have nice setups ready, go in your browser window and select mixer presets. Then just drag them on your mixer and the inside will be edited according to such presets chosen. In FL it's very common to change properties in time. For example, let's see how to change channel volume in time. There are two ways to do this. The easiest way is to right-click on any property and go to Edit Events. You can do this with all knobs, buttons, icons you have in FL. The new window Events is an unique graph on which you can draw how the property selected and represented in the title, in this case the volume, has to change in time. Mind that such graph can be changed according to the kind of property to edit. For example, volume has just positive and continuous values. Panning is continuous, but has negative values, which means putting more output on the left channel. Some others, like the on-off button, is discrete and admits just all on or all off. In the top left corner, you need to keep some buttons in mind. The brush button spreads the graph continuously, making a very personalized shape, whereas the pencil one spreads it in a discrete way, following the grid on the background. You can change the length of each grid cell by going on the magnet symbol. To delete the graph drawn and make all original, just use the delete icon and select parts or the whole graph. However, using Edit Events changes properties in time wherever the channel is used. Once it is set, it will always change in time, unless you delete the graph inserted. So the effect is applied whether if the channel is played in path mode or in song mode. If you want to manage better the changes in time, it is better to use the automation clips. These do the same of the events graph, but it is easier to handle. Let's change volume and vary it again. You can do it in many ways. Let's pick the volume knob in the pattern. Right-click on it and go to Create Automation Clip. This can be done with any property, just like the Edit Events action. When you do such, a new channel will appear in different color. This is not an usual channel that has sound or output. This is just a function that has effects just when in song mode. Open the playlist window and spread the opened pattern. By default, the automation clip is added in a track in the playlist. You can manage it like a normal pattern. Its title describes where the automation is acting. There is the channel name and then its property modified. You can edit its graph working directly with the mouse. The light points state the value of the property at that particular point, that can be editing dragging the point itself. Between two light points, you find other points that lets you set better the shape of the curve in between. Right-click on the curve to add more light points and set personalized graphs. Right-click on a light point to delete it or set particular shapes you have in the list. Otherwise, you can go to Channel Settings and put Oscillation through LFO section. You can create automation clips on automation clips indeed. For example, let's suppose to vary the automation graph in time. Go to LFO in Channel Settings and create an automation clip for the frequency with the SPD knob. Then change its graph and make it increasing. If you play the song, you will see the frequency oscillation changing in the first automation clip added. So you can see that even automation clips can have automation clips linked. Very well, this is all. Check our other videos in this show to go on with effects and beats. Thanks for watching.